I can't beat that. Let's just bring on Leona Williams.
All right.
All right. Come on, Leona. Come around and kiss everybody, Leona.
How you doing, Ralph?
Leona, you'll need to put a little microphone on there, darling.
Well, I'll talk to you if you want me to while you're doing it. Go ahead.
I'm ready. Are you ready? George, when this idea for the album with all the girls came up, did you pick the girls?
Well, I tell you, I love a lot of all these girls, entertainers that I have on the album. They're all outstanding artists in their own right, and I just love them to death, and they're very great people. And I'm a little partial to Leona Williams and Terry Gibbs, because not that I don't love the other ones, because I do. I think they're fantastic. But they're just a little more down to earth and, well, now that's not making sense either, because everybody, we're all down to earth in country music. I didn't mean it that way. I'm just close to them. Let me put it that way, and okay. I'll shut up while I'm ahead.
Leona, I think we have a copy of your new album, your solo album.
Yes, it's just fixing to be released next week.
What's the name of it? Do we have a picture of that? I think we can do that. When does it come out?
On the 18th is release date. It's called Someday When Things Are Good.
Oh, right. Which is a song you wrote.
That's right.
Which Merle Haggard had out as a number one record.
Who's that? Oh, Merle Haggard.
I used to know him.
All right, now we're looking at it. There it is. And this will be out...
the 18th.
Okay, mm-hmm. Next week.
Right.
Okay. What we're going to do, we're going to take a little break here, and then we're going to bring back best friends George and Leona. Okay?
Nashville Now has more live from America's country home coming up. You're watching the Nashville Network.
I thought I would sit over here with John Anderson so we could get a better look at Merle and Leona. You ready?
Oh, certainly.
Okay,
certainly.
Here we go. This is the first of two tunes from the album that George Jones does with about, I guess, 10 ladies in Music City. And this is the cut called Best Friends with George Jones and Leona and Leona Williams. I almost said Anderson.
I know you've been down just as far as a good man can go. And I know you've been hurt more than once, and the healing's been slow. But you're on your way to recovery, and you're not alone. 'Cause George Nash loves you, and she's gonna take care of old Jones. So cry on the shoulder, and let's both get over the pain. And let's write it off as just one more bad memory we've had. Friendship's the one thing that keeps love from dry. Cry on the shoulder of the best friends that we've ever had.
Well, I know you left Haggard, I knew by the words in his song. And I know that you're wondering all night, sitting alone. But I know you still love him, 'cause you're always there when he calls. And always remember you're his favorite memory of all.
Let's write it off as just one more bad memory we've had.
One more bad.
Short ones there or something.
Did you hit a bad note, George?
Yeah, I hit a bad one. My goodness.
Why,
I
never I told hit you. A bad note?
They won't. You wouldn't let me rehearse. I told you.
I wouldn't let you rehearse. I don't even come out here to music rehearsal, George. You can't put that on me.
You promised me if I came down the show, you'd let me rehearse enough to where I could get it right.
Well, we were all out here, too, this afternoon, George, waiting on you.
I can't argue with that.
Leona, was that the first time that you and George have done that song since you recorded the two?
Well, we did it a few times on the shows, on the road and stuff. We get to work together.
Yeah, that don't count.
Well, that's true.
This was the first time on television.
First time on television.
Yeah, I was scared to death, wasn't you?
Well, I really
wasn't. Tell me you wasn't.
I was proud because I'd wrote the song and...
Oh, you wrote that song.
I was proud to get to sing it with my favorite singer.
Fantastic.
Did you, George, who picked the songs for the album? The guests themselves, or did you pick them?
Well, you know, Billy Sherrill okays them and everything. We just sort of like a family type thing. We all get together up there in Billy's office, and Leona comes up, Barbara or Terry or whoever it is, and we kind of play them what they might have, you know, what they wrote, or, and if we like it and Billy likes it, and we just go ahead and do it. So it's kind of between the family, you know.
Okay, it's a democratic process. Everybody gets to vote.
Very democratic.
Okay. All right, George, I'm going to put you on the spot.
Oh, my goodness. John, I'm going to call you to my rescue.
Now, I'm going to say present company accepted, okay?
Right.
I have asked more country singers in various interviews who their favorite country singer is, and most of them have responded George Jones. Who is George Jones' favorite country singer?
Well, and I have to have two of them, right?
Okay, you can have as many as you want.
Well, I gotta have a female and a male, you know.
All right.
Right? Well, Connie Smith has got to be my favorite.
Yes?
and Merle Haggard's got to be my boy.
Connie Smith and Merle Haggard. That's a pretty interesting choice.
They ought to do a duet together. I've never understood why they do.
That's a good idea.
I'd love to hear them two do a duet together.
Hag may be watching tonight. He called me the night before last. I had just gotten to bed. It was the night we did the Statler Brothers. I had just gotten in bed, and the show reruns a second time at 11 o'clock. And I said, what are you doing? I said, where are you? He said, I'm home. I said, what are you doing? He said, I'm watching you. He said, I watch you every night. So I assume he's off the road right now. George, you've got another duet to do.
Oh, my goodness.
Terry Gibbs is coming up here in just a second. We're going to take a little break here, and we'll be right back in a moment.